these two alliances closely. On the blue alliance, we have Shockwave, ranked in number 4 here in these qualification matches. On the red alliance, we have Nerdherd, ranked number 10, and Bare Metal, ranked number 6. There's going to be a lot of action during this. We're expecting to see some scoring, maybe some heavy defense. Blue alliance, we have hatch panels going on both rockets simultaneously. But we have 4309, the botsmith, moving into position to do some defending. Are they going to be able to tie up both alliance robots here? At the moment, they seem to be making it difficult to get that rope, that hatch panel placed on the blue rocket. The hatch panel is there, but it's hanging by a thread. Hanging by the weakest thread, 28-26, a score of only 2 points difference. That's the hatch panel difference in this match. Shockwave finding a place to put that cargo into the blue cargo ship, and there it goes. 29-28, down playing defense on the red end of the field. Viking Robotics trying to tie up the red robots to keep them from scoring. But 20-46, in goes a cargo into the red robot. Into the red rocket. Into the red rocket, 49 red. 32 blue. So a little bit of an advantage to red as we come down to 50 seconds left in this match. There goes cargo into the blue. They add 3 more points to the blue score. Cargo into the red, the answer, red cargo ship. There are the answers just like that. We're looking for the red robot trying to get back into the cargo, but they're being tied up. A lot of defense going on here. 44-88 Shockwave trying to get one more piece of cargo into that rocket. They're being slowed down. They lose that cargo. As the botsmiths retreat back to try to make their climb, 44-88 up onto the high half. 20-46, Bare Metal on the bottom of the high cab. Not sure that 4088 made it. They appear to be still resting on the lower level of the cab. We'll be back with the final score for qualification match number 36 after a quick review by the refs. Match there, Brett, and I know you have something to show us.